So let's go through the pros and cons of studying a large, huge course versus a smaller, much more compact course in today's video. Welcome back. My name is Tim Buchalka with another programming tip of the day. And we're talking about going through a small course, a small programming course, or a large one. Now, I'm going to use the example here of two courses that I've got on Udemy, the Java Masterclass course, which is a massive course, 77 hours of content, and a much smaller Java Crash course. But this will apply to any large and small course, because invariably, when you're starting out to become a programmer, when you're looking for different programming courses, you'll find that there's a huge course, invariably, and a smaller course. Well, firstly, in general, it depends, what are you trying to achieve? Are you looking to just brush up your skills? In other words, have you got some programming experience? If so, perhaps the Crash course is probably all you need. The reasoning behind that is you've got some programming experience. You don't need to know absolutely everything about a particular programming language or whatever the topic is of the course. You're just wanting to brush up your skills. So maybe a Crash course is for you. Also, if you're on a deadline and you've got a limited amount of time and you need to get up to speed quickly, a Crash course can be useful. But bear in mind also with that, if you're looking for the quickest possible way to become a programmer, then it's probably false economy to just think that if I take the smallest course, I'm going to learn the quickest, because that's really not how things work. It will apply more if you're coming from another programming language or you've got some programming skills, you can probably get away with a smaller course. If you're starting from scratch though, generally, I would recommend you take the larger course. And the reason is that they're generally they're more comprehensive, and depending on the course, but usually they're aimed at beginners. So they don't make any assumptions on what you do or don't know, and they actually include a wide breadth of topics and subtopics within whatever the course topic is that you'll learn from. So the Java Masterclass, getting back to that analogy, teaches all sorts of things that you can find very useful in Java, but you may not be using a lot. So for example, Java FX, there's a whole section in that course on Java FX. This is the Masterclass. And that relates to learning how to create desktop GUIs in Java. Now, that's a very specialized skill that you may never have to do. You might never get into that situation where you'll need to learn those skills as a programmer. However, having said that, it can be a useful skill to learn, plus some of the techniques that are taught in that section of the course are applicable outside or in other areas of Java. So in general, what I would say is that the larger course, if you're someone who hasn't programmed before or hasn't programmed for some time, go for the larger course and just do everything. Even though there's sections there that you may not be interested in or you think you'll never use, just go through the course and finish that anyway, and put that on your basically something you're adding it to your resume is what I'm trying to say. Be able to add it, and it's just a good skill to have should you ever need it in the future. So that's the pros and cons. In general, I would steer you towards a larger course, but you have got the option of a crash course or a smaller course if you're just looking to basically brush up on your skills quickly and you've already got some programming experience. Alrighty, so I hope that helped. If you've got any questions, feel free to leave a comment and I'll get back to you. If you're ready to look at the next tip, click on up here and you can check that out. If you're interested in coding specific programming videos, click on the link in the bottom left-hand corner. Consider subscribing by clicking on the link up here, and I'll see you soon.